everyone. This is Noelle for Petitti Garden Centers, and we were just talking perennials for the shade, so I thought, hey, why not? Let's talk shrubs for the shade too, and at least you'll get some idea of what plants, what woody ornamentals are going to work very well in your shade garden or shady areas. Now again, shade gardens are usually considered areas that have 4 hours or less of direct sunlight, and all these that you'll see here will do very, very nicely. Now granted, many of these plants will be spring blooming, but I wanted you to see the foliage and the texture and the color of the foliage, because they can provide other ornamental interest after the springtime. So the first one, actually, this is Mountain Fire Pieris japonica. This is a very, very popular plant, and you can see why. It blooms these little white bells in the spring, which are very pretty, but the foliage, the new foliage that comes out on this plant, turns a bright red, and it's evergreen. So you'll see this plant year round, and it'll always be producing more color for you. This white flowering plant up here, this is summer sweet clethra. And what we love about this plant is that it blooms now. So basically mid to late summer, it's in its bloom heyday. And you can tell the pollinators love this plant, including hummingbirds. And it is very fragrant in the garden. So if you do enjoy fragrance, you enjoy cut flowers, you enjoy the pollinators, this is a great plant to have. So clethra comes in pink and white typically. The next one here is rhododendron. This is Dandyman. This is a great new rhododendron from Proven Winners, and it has got some beautiful purple flowers on it in the springtime. But you can see that foliage is very, very ornamental, has kind of an umbrella type look, so it's very pretty in the garden and very disease resistant. Down below, I have another white flowering plant, and this is actually shooting up a second bloom cycle for us. This is Fothergilla Mount Airy. And what we love about Fothergilla is it's in the witch hazel family, and it produces a lot of fall color. The fall show on this plant is spectacular. So hopefully later in the season, we can show you when it's in full color. But your spring blooming, your green foliage has a slightly bronze tinge to it. It's really, really nice. Next to that is Rainbow Lakothi. This is actually a shorter, low habit type evergreen. It looks like this year round, folks. And if you put it out in too much sun, these white or creamy parts will burn. So just be aware, it really is best in the shade garden, well-drained soil, beautiful color year round. Down behind it is an oak leaf hydrangea. This is actually Snow Queen. Snow Queen, this one is just kind of towards the end of its first bloom cycle. It is producing a few more buds here. But what's great about the oak leaf hydrangea is they're the most shade tolerant. Most of your mophead hydrangeas want about 6 hours of direct sunlight. So we would call that part shade. You wouldn't want to put them in too deep of shade. They really won't produce for you, but the oak leaf will. So the oak leaf is really, really the best choice for those shady spots. Down below here, we've got boxwood, and boy, you can throw boxwood just about anywhere. This one's Winter Gem. It's a nice, round, very glossy leaf, beautiful little boxwood plant. You can throw them just about anywhere you like. And then this tall one right here is actually a viburnum. Viburnum bloom great in the springtime, produce those white sort of clustered flowers, gorgeous in the spring. Some are very, very fragrant. But what's great about them is that you go through the summer and that foliage starts to change. The flowers will start to turn into berries, which are great for attracting the birds to the yard. And they are fantastic. This particular variety is Red Balloon. And I love how Red Balloon has this really white bark. It's really, really showy, and of course you're going to see a lot of red berries produced on this plant as well. So all of these plants are really great shade, 4 hours or less, again, shady areas that you can plant and get a lot of ornamental color interest, and again, spring blooming. Enjoy.